2016. We have worked very hard to get to this point, and we have also endured many hardships in our lives. The time to graduate and become an adult has finally arrived, and I am very pleased to finish out at Brooklyn Baptist Academy. Along my journey, I have encountered many people who have helped me and have also encouraged me to be the person that I am today, and I thank each and every one of you for everything. We have conquered the first race, the first lap in the race of life, but that doesn't mean we have finished the race completely. It only gets more challenging from this point forward. I would like to thank all the people who made me feel welcomed and at home in Brooklyn. I would like to thank all the faculty for having the determination to prepare me for college and beyond. Your classes have not only been helpful in a spiritual way, but have given me a glimpse into what to expect when entering a collegiate atmosphere. You have also taught me that in the end, it doesn't matter how many A's you have made on tests. What will matter is what you have learned and how you are applying it into your everyday life. Brother Harder, you have really impacted my life spiritually this year. All of your years of studying God's Word and also living for Jesus Christ have been an example to me on how I should live my life for the Lord. Your Bible classes have given me knowledge that I never would have known. Your teachings and determination to preach God's Word have not been in vain. Thank you for being such an example in my life. Coach Harder, the motivation that you have given me means everything to me. Playing softball for you has taught me many things, not only how to play first base, but also how to stay calm spiritually and that everything we do on and off the field is all for the glory of God. I couldn't thank you enough for the compassion and the love you have shown me this year. I'm really going to miss you, Coach. To my parents, thank you for putting me in such a school as Brooklyn. Dad, even though times got hard when it came to chemistry, you were still the main person that never stopped pushing me. At times I didn't like it, but thanks to you, I won't be back next year. Mom, thank you for teaching me how to push through the hard times. You would never let me give up on myself. You always told me to focus on me because I'm the only one who truly knows how much I can take. I love both of you with all of my heart. I can truly say I've been blessed with the best surroundings. Most importantly, I would like to thank my Heavenly Father above for everything He has done. He has blessed me so much in my life. A blessing that I will never forget is when God sent His Son, Jesus Christ, to die and suffer on the cross for my sins so that I have eternal life through Him. He is the ultimate reason that I'm standing here tonight. Without my Heavenly Father, nothing would be possible. He has and never will give up on me, even when I have given up on myself. My friends, the tears you wiped, the hugs you have given, and the laughs you have shared will never be forgotten. My love for you is indescribable. My love grows stronger every day. You have stuck with me through thick and thin. I love you all so much. I can never thank you enough. You have made this year worthwhile, whether we played sports together or just hung out. There are some that I have met and become so close to, to the point I call them my brothers and sisters. My advice to my friends, be who God wants you to be. Be unique and one of a kind, just as God made you. As we leave this phase in our lives and enter a darkened world, let us be resplendent lighthouses, guide others towards Jesus Christ. All of our memories we have made this year, all the friendships we have gained will enhance the accomplishments in our lives that are yet to come. Continue to grow in faith and responsibility.